Casual employment refers to a situation in which an employee is only guaranteed work when it is needed, with no knowledge of when there will be work in the future. Most of the casual workers are engaged on temporary basis and sign six-month contracts subject to renewal. A number of companies engage casual workers, and according to the Industrial and Commercial Workers Union, most of the casual workers do not enjoy the benefits due permanent staff. According to the union, most casual workers are exploited and paid below the deserved wages. The General Secretary of ICU, Mr. Solomon Kote, at the union's 11th quadrennial conference in Tema, said some casual workers in Tema have worked for the same company for over 20 years and said the situation is unacceptable. Mr. Kote said the government must clear the air about casual employment and how long one can remain a casual worker.
Successive government and current government have not responded to the issues of casualization. This is putting money in wrong pockets. This is making employers to benefit from what they have not sold. And as a national union, we are never tired to draw me down until our prayer on casualization is heard. I therefore will endorse fully the permission to have a demonstration in Tema where a lot of these casual workers' issues are surrounding and hanging on our necks. Go to Cocoa Board and you find somebody casual for 20 years. Come over to PFC and you find people casual for over 15 years. What are we waiting for?
Mr. Solomon Kote also said the government must strengthen the National Health Insurance Scheme and bring to book persons responsible for the collapse of the banks. The ICU is also asking for taxes to be lowered, especially with the country coming out of a difficult time as a result of the coronavirus. In his regional report, the Tema regional chairman of the ICU, Mr. Samuel Ananga, said workers in the region still face redundancy, indiscriminate dismissal, and other labor issues, creating tension between workers and their employers.
A number of workers in Abna's industry were mysteriously terminated for not showing up for public holiday work. Can you imagine? Somebody says, it's my day, I won't come. And you say, I will terminate you. This is their story. So the matter, as usual, was reported to the National Labor Commission. After several cities, the commission is now set to give us the ruling.
New leaders for Tema were elected and sworn in to steer affairs of the union for the next 4 years.